We need, in some cases, high-pressure systems. Sometimes we need high-pressure systems because I want to have remote cylinder placement. I want to actually, instead of having the cylinders in the room, I want to have them outside of the protected hazard in another space. Sometimes I want to gang them all together and group them. And so I typically, to be able to do that, I'm going to wind up with longer pipe runs. That's why I need higher pressure systems. There are three categories of high pressure systems out there: 500 PSI systems, 725 PSI systems, and then nitrogen driver systems, sort of a hybrid type of arrangement. The other thing that we can do with a high pressure system is build a zoned system. So now we add in valves to the system so we direct where the agent goes. In this case, we've got one cylinder or one bank of cylinders that can protect four different hazards within that building. And at each one of these three locations, there are these three-way zone valves. And through the program of the panel, we open them up to the correct area before we discharge the gas, so that if the fire is in zone four, I'll make sure that the gas goes to zone four instead of going to those other units. I can save myself expense when I have multiple hazards I want to protect with clean agent by using that type of system. So the 500 PSI systems is the first high pressure system we're going to talk about. There are a couple manufacturers that purchase this or that create these systems. These are limited to only Novec 1230. They still use the same construction method, mild steel shells with welds, and there are selector valves available for these. There's probably three manufacturers that make this type of system. There's 725 PSI systems, a little higher pressure. That higher pressure changes the construction type of the pressure vessel, and so there's a little more cost to these types of systems. But because of the changed construction, I can now use both FM200 and Novec 1230 in my spun steel cylinder. So that's just that spun steel versus welded steel are the ways that we make these cylinders. Now, because they're higher pressure, I can compress the gas and the nitrogen agent down farther, and so I can ultimately result with smaller cylinder sizes containing the same amount of agent. And so in really big systems, I can enjoy a smaller footprint because my cylinders are smaller physically. But, in a lot of the systems that get installed, I'll never really see that benefit because we just don't install huge gas systems a lot in the United States. This is another system that allows to use selector valves. The last high pressure system I want to talk about is the KITA ADS system. It uses both Novec 1230 and FM200. And so it has a sidecar nitrogen driver. So you can see in this picture here, this black cylinder is the high pressure nitrogen cylinder that discharges through a flexible hose into the standard pressure agent cylinder through the use of a small orifice plate, which drops the pressure into the standard pressure system. That nitrogen gives it all the extra motive force to push the gas a long distance through the pipes. It has selector valves available, and again, this is available through KITA fire systems. Its hardware, except for the add-on high pressure nitrogen cylinders, is all similar to the standard pressure cylinders out there using welded steel shells. There is a little cost benefit for the extra nitrogen cylinders out there, but what we get as a benefit is we get the longest possible pipe run. So we can push agent over 200 feet, and we've calculated over 250 foot from the agent cylinders to the first tee, which is really in a standard pressure system you'd never get to 100 feet long. The KITA system also allows for expanded nozzle coverage. FM200 has a best-in-class nozzle coverage with their system up to 56 foot by 46 coverage rectangle. In Novec, there's one other manufacturer that can go as big as that KITA can go with a 42 foot coverage square. In their Novec 1230 offering, they've also done some height improvements, which can be useful for system designers where they want to limit the amount of tiered nozzles that they have, because the maximum nozzle height for this system is 18 feet 6 inches, and then there's a maximum distance from the nozzle outlet to the highest nozzle now with a KITA system of 40 feet. So that with this system, you might be able to locate the agent cylinders on a different level of the building than where you actually have the hazard. When should you use high pressure systems? Well, When you have limited space for the cylinders close to the hazard, where you desire centralized agent storage so that you can consolidate those cylinders for inspection and maintenance, where I want to protect multiple rooms from a single cylinder bank and through the use of selector valves, and then in some cases where I've got a really complex pipe layout. The front-end designer that's specifying the system may not know that complex pipe layout issue. That may be an issue that gets brought up by the installing contractor that's doing the actual flow calculations for the system. They may realize they need to switch over to use a high-pressure system. So it's important for you to write your specifications such that you can be flexible between the two systems.